So far, we have learned about the basic concepts of TF and a few command line tools to investigate transform information related to a given ROS application. Now, let's recall that we started our TF adventure in the last module to be able to transform the pose of an object detected by the logical camera to a target reference frame, and eventually we can use this pose to actually grasp the object using the pick and place pipeline we made in week 4. So, in this video, we will learn about a few simple APIs of the TF2 underscore ROS package to be able to achieve these goals. The first API we will learn about is the TF buffer, which is extremely useful. TF buffer caches transform information for a specified duration. As a result, we can overcome the potential time synchronization problems between query and TF information availability that we discussed in the previous videos with the command line tools. We can declare a TF buffer like this, and without any argument, the default duration of buffering TF information is 10 seconds. But we could also define a buffer by explicitly specifying a desired duration like this. Once we have a buffer defined, we need to be able to fill it in with information. We can do this with a transform listener, which subscribes internally to the TF topic. We can utilize the transform listener API of the TF2 underscore ROS package for this purpose, like shown here. And we pass the TF buffer as an argument so that the transform information gets stored in the buffer. Once we have the information stored in the buffer, we can use the stored information to transform a pose from a source frame to a target frame. We will learn two APIs in this regard, namely, the lookup underscore transform API and the transform API. Now, before we start playing with the APIs, let's have a quick look and a quick understanding of how the transform buffer works. So, we start with the same timeline or the time-based axis as we saw a couple of videos ago. Now, the TF buffer is something that can store information for a specified duration. And what information does it store? TF messages from the TF topic. So, as and when the TF topic is published, the TF messages in the TF topic get stored in the buffer. And then the next publication of the TF topic is also buffered. I mean, the information in the TF topic is also buffered, because the complete duration of the buffer has not yet been occupied. And this continues until the buffer is full. And the buffer continues to store information by replacing older TF data as and when new TF data comes in, so that there is always TF information available over a specified duration, that is the size of the buffer. This way, the buffer always has the latest available transform information of all published TF frames on the slash TF topic. Now, of course, if we query for a transform before the first TF data is available, or if we query for something which is not in the buffer, we will still have warnings or errors like we saw earlier. But that is not very likely to happen. And we will find out how to get around those errors. In summary, we have learned in this video that we can create a TF buffer, and then we can update the TF buffer via the TF listener. This sets up everything we need to use the lookup underscore transform and the transform APIs, which we will learn using code illustrations in the next video.